Okay, good morning students. Welcome to class unit 3. Today we are going to learn about the impact of British rule in India. Yes. Regarding this topic, we are going to learn some important factors that are administrative and judicial system. Under this point, we are learning about some important another factors are civil services, judicial system, police system, military system, and another important factor, land tax policies like permanent zamindar system, mahalwari system, rightwari system. And another learning point regarding this topic is modern education. Lord Macaulay, Woods Commission, and the laws during British rule like regulating rule, Pitt's India laws, and charter laws. Before going to learn, we are going to learn background of these policies. The British East India Company started in 1600 AD or CE, Common Era. This company fulfilled its commercial needs in the beginning as a trade company. On observing the fractured political landscape of India, wherein hundreds of ruling dynasties were competing with each other, the British thought of exploiting the situation to further their political consolidation. So, they implemented some policies like divide and rule policy. Wars were employed by British, and also simultaneously the negotiation methods cleverly they employed. After getting India under control by the employing various clever means, the British thought of strengthening their hold over India permanently. Then India was a divide of one nation concept and was scattered into various kingdoms. The British integrated the whole of India under one administrative and political structure like education, judiciary, land taxes, trade and agriculture, and other various areas of activities were regulated under various laws and administrative system. This brought in a new structure to India. While implementing all these measures, they never forgot to protect their financial interests. The British East India Company implemented various administrative experiments in order to achieve a new order in India. So, we are going to discuss first in this unit, we are going to learn the first learning point, the administrative and judicial system. Under this, they employ many civil services. Lord Cornwallis, you learned in the previous classes, Lord Cornwallis introduced the administration of civil services. Even today also, for employing IAS and IPS officers, also facing competitive exams. These competitive examinations conducted in those days, civil services examinations was conducted first time in India by the Lord Cornwallis. The system of appointing employees for the purpose of trade was done by the East India Company from the beginning. The company also provided permission for private workers to trade. By using these opportunities, employers made money become corrupt through illegal means. So to control this, in 1773, the government of England implemented an act, that is Regulating Act in India. Okay, when did Regulating Act implement in India? 1773. The aim of Regulating Act was, the name suggests to enforce control. In 1800 common era, Lord Cornwallis opened Fort William College in Calcutta for the benefit of people aspiring to join civil services. Actually, this was a very good concept, was implemented by the Lord Cornwallis in those days. But this initiation, this Lord Cornwallis initiation, did not find support from the directors of the East India Company. As a result, all the appointments till 1853 CE were done by the directors directly. From 1853 CE onwards till 1853, civil service appointments were only by the directors of East India Company. But after 1853 common era onwards, the appointments of civil services were done through competitive examinations. Even today, many civil service examinations like IAS, IPS and IFS and many other civil services examination also conducted through the competitive exams in the present days also. After 1853, that was appointments of civil services were done by the competitive examinations. This did not benefit Indians much. In those days, not now, in those days, the appointment method of civil services through the competitive examination was not a help to Indians, were not benefit to Indians much. Because in those days, British continued to suspect the efficiency of Indians. They treat as the Indians are not fit for civil administration. So Lord Cornwallis argued. What did he argue? This is very important. Note down the point of Lord Cornwallis. This was a very shame for Indians. What did his argue? Let us learn. According to Lord Cornwallis, all the natives of Hindustan are completely corrupt. As a result, only lower grade jobs were given to Indians. Like clerk, accountant, some other small jobs were given to Indians only. Not IAS, IPS, IFS examinations are not fit for Indians, like argued by Lord Cornwallis. So, the judicial system was introduced by the British East India Company in those days. A new judicial system started finding roots when the British rule began taking over from the Mughal rule. Yes. After the Battle of Buxar, the Mughal Emperor Shah Alam handed over the Diwani rights to the British East India Company in those days. After that, the authority to collect the land taxes to the British. With this dual administration, that Robert Clive was introduced to a dual administration system, came into effect in Bengal region. This is also called dual governance. Under this, the authority to collect land taxes, civil and judiciary were given to the Indian officials. Whereas the British retained the authority managing the revenue collected. Later on, the British thought of bringing more centralized the judicial system in India. With the implementation of this system, the British overtook the authority of the Mughal and established their supremacy in India. This was attained by implementing new judicial system in India. According to the administrative plan devised by Warren Hastings, who took over the administration as governor in 1772 CE, there were two types of courts needed to be established in each district. In those days, at the time of 1772, from the Lord Hastings, he introduced the two types of courts were needed to establish in each district. One is a Diwani Adalat. That Diwani Adalat courts are working as a civil court. It works as a civil court. And another is Fauzdari Adalat as a criminal court. One is a Diwani Adalat, it has a civil court. And another one is a fauzdari adalat as a criminal court. In these civil courts, Hindus were dispensed justice as per Hindu scripture and Muslims as per the Sharia. Slowly, the British legal procedures were introduced in the criminal courts. See how discrimination was done by the British officers in those days. Civil courts were run by Hindus, and criminal courts were run by British. What discrimination in those days? Civil courts came under the administration of European officers. To the criminal courts were under the control of quasis. The criminal courts were under the control of quasis. They were functioning under the supervision of European officers. See, after we learn the judicial system, another system was introduced by the British East India Company, that is police system. The police are in charge of maintaining the internal law and order situation. Internal law and order situation. Lord Carnarvon Wallis implemented the efficient police system in India for the first time. See, this is also very important point note down in the history of India. The first time the efficient police officers should be need to maintaining the law and order. This system was introduced by the Lord Carnarvon Wallis first time in India. He created the new post of superintendent of police. Nowadays, we can see every district has a superintendent of police, SP. He divided a district into many stations and put every station under a kotwal, named as a kotwal. Similarly, he put every village under the care of kotwal. After chowkidar and kotwal, under the care of kotwal, after one more officer, his name kotwal, was made accountable for thefts in the villages, crimes and others, law violations at the village level. But see, here the new post was introduced by the Lal Carnarvon Wallis, that is SP, superintendent of police. After that, he divided the district into many stations, put every station under a kotwal. Similarly, put every village under the care of the kotwal. In each village or group of some village, he appointed another police officer. His name was kotwal. His work was for controlling the thefts and crimes and other law violations at village level only. The severe drought of 1773 led to the weak law and order situation. Else, the entire police system was brought under the control of the British officers. The system of appointing the British magistrates. Magistrates are like judges in courts. Started in 1781 CE. The police officers were under the power of magistrates. Yes, these police system was controlled under the magistrates. The police system underwent continuous changes for some after a period, many after 10 years, after some years. In 1861, see, the police law was implemented. This law is the base of good law and order administration. But Indians were not appointed for the post officers. In 1906, the police commission law allowed the appointment of suitable educational qualification for the post of the police officers. In spite of all these measures, the discrimination against the Indians did not end. Okay. After all, military system of British East India Company. The military was the base of administration during the British. Military was the base of administration. The British appointed the Indians for the military and took entire India under their control with the help of military. They protect their supremacy by addressing the challenges posed by the outside as well as inside forces with the help of the military. The officers were again the British. The Indians could reach the rank of Subedar. That much is enough. The highest post available to them. That was the highest post. Subedar post was the highest post for Indians. Most of the Indians were coolie soldiers only. The British government accepted the recommendations of Peel in 1857 CE. Based on these recommendations, because after 1857, the British Queen recommended some important rules. According to the base of those recommendations, the military system was redesigned. After they introduced some land taxes policies, the East India Company had to pay £4 lakh to the British government for its control over Bengal province. Hence, it implemented many new land tax policies. Because even the British East India Company paid £4 lakh to the British government, which is in England. So, the British East India Company collected the new land taxes from the Bengal provinces and it hand over the money to the British government which was in England. Then introduced a permanent zamindar system. Lord Cornwallis implemented a new land tax policy in Bengal, in Bihar regions. Yes. Where did the permanent zamindar system was implemented? In the region of Bengal and Bihar regions. Very good. When did permanent zamindar system was implemented? In 1793 CE. Implemented zamindar system in the Bengal and Bihar regions. Order to generate steady revenue per annum. This was called permanent zamindari system. Yes. In order to generate steady revenue per annum continuously, they got revenue from the regarding region. This was called permanent zamindar system. What are the features of permanent zamindar system let us discuss. Zamindar became the landowner. Zamindar became the landowner. The zamindar was expected to pay the agreed land taxes to the company on a set date every year. See, understood? He was free to collect any amount of land taxes from the farmers and could retain the excess money collected. Yes. Once again, I would like to review the same point feature. Zamindar became the landowner, first thing. Then, zamindar was expected to pay the agreed land taxes to the company on a set date every year. He was free to collect any amount of land taxes from the farmers and could retain the excess money collected. Both the zamindar and the company were benefited by this permanent zamindar system. But the farmers were the grave sufferers. This system created a new social group that aided the British. The farming laborers suffered due to irregular working opportunities in the farming lands. They were exploited and had to lead a life of insecurity. So, this system was extended to Bihar, not only in Bengal region. Afterwards, when they knew, they got much income from the regarding region. Afterwards, extended the zamindari system in Bihar, Odisha, Andhra and Varanasi regions later. According to Charles Metcalf, the Indian farmers were born in debit, lived in debit and died in debit due to the land tax policies of the British. Yes. See, according to Charles Metcalf, what did he tell? The Indian farmers were born in debit, lived in debit and died in debit due to loss of his money. Okay? Stop. Okay. One more land tax policy was also introduced by British East India Company. That is Mahalwari system. Yes. That Mahalwari system. Okay. Who was introduced or who did implement Mahalwari system? Yes. Mahalwari system was implemented by R.M. Burr and James Thomson. Yes, these two persons were implemented the Mahalwari system. Okay, let us see what are all the features of Mahalwari system we shall discuss. Since the company officials fixed more land tax, How much land tax they have to fix? They fix the land tax more than the expected production from the fields. Many zamindars had to lose their ownership of the lands. Only the marginal farmers and agricultural laborers who are dependent on these zamindari zamindars also suffered due to this malwares. Even the big and small zamindars were also part of this system. So the company government entered an agreement at the level of mahals. Mahal means, in those days, mahal means taluks. Entered an agreement at the level of taluks or mahals with regard to payment of land tax in a certain area, that is Uttar Pradesh. In those days, they implemented the Malwari system in Uttar Pradesh and many other parts of North India. They are Madhya Pradesh, even Punjab, Delhi also. They fixed land tax in these states. And one more land tax policy was also introduced by the British East India Company. Yes. What was that? Anyone can tell? Yes, very good. Raitwari system. Raitwari system was also implemented as a land tax policy. In nowadays also, many land tax policies are also introduced by the central government and also in the state government. Today also, in the Vidhan Sabha, they want to try to pass many bills like land farms. So, like in those days, the British officers also introduced many land tax policies. Among the land tax policy, the Raitwari system is also one of the land tax policy. This was introduced by Alexander Reed in the 1792 Common Era, where British East India Company was implemented the Raitwari system in India, in the southern part of India. Where exactly? Yes, very good. Baramahal. They implemented the Raitwari system in the region of Baramahal. This system was later implemented also in Madras and Mysore regions also. But in the Madras and Mysore regions, implemented by Thomas Munro. When did Raitwari system was introduced in Mysore and Madras regions? In 1801 Common Era, was by Thomas Munro. Yes. What are all the features of Raitwari system we shall discuss now? Under the Raitwari system, both the farmer and the company, here see, understand, both the farmer and the company were directly linked. The first feature of Raitwari system, the tiller of the land was recognized as the owner of the land. The owner had to pay 50% of produce as land tax to the government. Then the land tax had 30 years tenure. Yes, this in Raitwari system, the land tax has fixed at 30 years tenure. The tax could be reviewed after this tenure also. After the 30 years, the again tax will be reviewed. To the small farmers who were given land ownership, they were subjected to more suffering due to rupee land tax. The officials took
need two actions to collect the land. The farmers have to borrow from the money lenders. They have collected the money from money lenders because they have to pay the land taxes for the government. So whenever the crops are failed, they have to sell their lands. Whenever they fail to repay the loans to the company, government claimed that the new system benefits the farmers. Here the irony was that more farmers had to lose their lands due to its implementation. Yes. Okay, let us discuss the impact of British land and tax.
Okay.
Let us learn what are the impacts of British land tax system in India in those days. Okay, we shall read a new class of zamindars who exploited the farmers was created. The second one is the farmers who were subject to the exploitation of zamindars became landless slowly. Then the land became a commodity. Loans could be raised by mortgaging the lands. Then many zamindars also had to mortgage their lands in order to pay the land tax. What situation was created in those days because of these land tax systems, even they have to pay the land tax, they have to mortgage their land and took the loan and pay the loan to the government. This was the situation was happened in those days. The agricultural sector became commercialized and had to grow raw materials needed by industries back in England. Then the money lenders became strong. Then these are all the important impacts of land tax policies. Okay, let us learn after the land tax policies. We learn many land tax policies like zamindari system, raipari system, and mahalwari system we read. Okay, next, what are other rules they have to implement in India? Yes, the modern education system. This was a very important thing we should know. New changes occurred during the British rule during the 18th century. During the 18th century, they have to make many rules to change the Indian system. So they have to start regarding these systems. They have to start. New schools were started, not for the Indians. Their aim, their objective was to start their school because of the children for British and Europeans living in India, who were living in India for during the British East India Company administration. Since these facilities were never extended to the locals, even new schools who were started in those days, not for Indian locals, those who are started because of the children of British and Europeans who were living in India, it was no use for our local Indian peoples. The war on the Hastings facilitated the expansion of the modern education in India. Yes, who was expansions the modern education in India? Lord Warren Hastings. Understand? Lord Warren Hastings was expanded the modern education in India. In 1781, CE started Calcutta, Madras. Then Duncan, Mohandas Duncan, a British individual, also he started Sanskrit College in Banaras in 1792 Common Era. He started Sanskrit College in the Banaras. Even this was also for British University, but it was Charles Grant who pressed for the universalization of British education in India. Then, after that, the emergence of modern education, after introduced by Lord Warren Hastings of Hastings for new education policies, for new education was introduced by Lord Warren Hastings. After the many rules came under the British East India Company, the expansion of the British education in India received special support after the appointment of William Bentinck as the Governor General of India. Yes, this William Bentinck appointed Macaulay as the member of Governor General's Executive Committee. He appointed a committee that is executive committee. That who appointed this executive committee? William Bentinck. Under the Macaulay. The Macaulay is the member of the Governor General of this executive committee. This Macaulay was also appointed as the chairperson of the committee later on education. The report on education submitted by him in 1835 Common Era became the base of the modern education in India. Indian policy aimed at the creation of a new class of Indians who are Indian by body. But British in intelligence, opinion and taste were different. They are modern education in India in his policy aimed. What was the aim? That the creation of new class of Indians who are Indian by body, but the British in intelligence, opinion and taste. See, the use of English medium in Indian learning system started after 1830s. The Governor General Lord Dalhousie, who implemented the doctrine of labs, Governor General Lord Dalhousie established many universities in those days in various places of India. In Calcutta, he established in Calcutta, Bombay, Madras. As per the suggestions of Charles Wood Commission, this Charles Wood Commission was appointed in 1854. Under the suggestion of Charles Wood Commission, Lord Dalhousie established many universities in the various places of India. They are in Calcutta, Bombay and Madras. After this, the education started becoming universalized in India. Yes. Then, what were all the impact of the British education in India? Yes. We shall read. The first important thing, what was the important impact from the British education system. Indians could develop modernity, secularism, democratic attitudes. Yes, see, Indians could develop their modernity, secularism, democratic attitudes and rationality along with the nationalistic ideals. Then another one, the impetus was received for the local literature and languages. This facilitated unity in thinking process among the educated classes. Then periodicals like newspapers, monthly newspapers, every day you can see the newspapers, like, so those who are called periodicals started emerging in those days after British introduced the education policies. These scrutinized the policies after Indians got a knowledge, because they learned English, they can understand what the British rule on Indians. So they scrutinized the policies and they working for the government, which in turn enabled the Indians to have critical opinions on various issues. Then new social and religious reformation movements emerged. In those days, after introduced the new education system by the British East India Company, the main impact also, this is also which was the main impact on Indians, the new social religious reformations movements emerged. Then the thoughts of thinkers like M.S. Mill, J.S. Mill, Rousseau, Montesquieu brought fresh thinking in the mind of educated youth of India. The freedom struggles that were the across the globe influenced the Indians. Indians could understand and appreciate their tradition. Okay, after that we shall read constitutional development. Yes, along with the British administration, problems also grew in India. In order to alleviate the problems, reformation in administration became important. The British attempted to create different rules in the form of law and try to implement them. These types of laws helped the evolution of constitution in India. We shall study this attempt in brief.